Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. At the time of recording this video, the launch of NROL 85 is scheduled to lift off in about an hour. So by the time this video is uploaded, it should be just about finished. We have another couple of launches coming up this week with another Starlink mission and another Crew Dragon mission to the ISS. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, the Starlink 4-14 mission is scheduled to lift off on Thursday 17th at 1:13 PM UTC or 9:23 AM EDT. In addition, there is a further launch scheduled for this coming week. Again, as you can see, the launch of the Crew 4 mission is scheduled to lift off on Saturday 23rd at 9:26 AM UTC or 5:26 AM EDT. NASA's Commercial Crew Twitter account posted a tweet with a picture of the Crew Dragon for the next crew mission. They said, "Welcome to NASA Kennedy Crew Dragon Freedom." The SpaceX capsule that will carry four astronauts to the space station arrived at Launch Complex 39A after making the journey from its nearby processing facility at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. There is an interesting article posted by Space News to share about a future Falcon 9 launch. It says NASA's embrace of reused rockets continued with an agreement this month to switch the upcoming launch of an Earth science satellite from a new to a previously flown Falcon 9, a change whose full terms remain proprietary. There's an article posted by Tasmanian to share about how Starlink is helping Ukrainian children. It says SpaceX's Starlink internet service is assisting Ukrainian children with life-threatening illnesses to get to safety. The Starlink satellite constellation is enabling patients and hospital staff to communicate with humanitarian aid in neighbouring European countries. This is possible thanks to a collaboration between SpaceX and Jude's Children's Research Hospital and Shift 4 Payments founder and SpaceX Inspiration 4 commander Jared Isaacman. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. Crews have been continuing to work on the chopstick catching arms. The wide bay construction elevator is now being disassembled. Some items were spotted delivered with a few people saying they are high-power entertainment lighting cabinets. SpaceX have started erecting a new tent in the production yard. Here's a view of groundwork for a possible new production building. I wanted to share a tweet posted by Everyday Astronaut with him and Elon Musk on the orbital launch tower at Starbase. Here's a view of a nose cone under construction in a tent. The original cargo door pathfinder stack has been moved. A newer, flatter bulkhead was moved onto the sleeving mount. It was also sleeved with a two-ring stack. The Ship 21 body, which has sat in the yard for a while, has now been cut up. Work has continued on the Ship 24 body section in the mid-bay. SpaceX have done some more Booster 7 testing on the structural test stand. There was also a cryogenic proof test performed with Booster 7. Here's a quick look at the closures on the Cameron County website. There is a possible closure scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 18th. The common dome and aft sections of Booster 8 were moved out into the yard. Then this Booster 8 section was also seen being stacked. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, known as Boca Chica Gala Nick Antuini, for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.